WAPT Scott Simmons. He's been weathering the storm out in the coast this morning. Hi, Scott.
Good morning once again, and we are still getting a good breeze coming off the bay here at Bay St. Louis, and some whitecaps over in the area over here. Of course, now the good news is we got some daylight. First time we've been for a couple of days, we're not being pounded by heavy rain. They need that breakdown here because the big problem has been this has been an unprecedented rain event. They've got so much rain, that wind pushing in, shoving that water inshore. It's backed up in numerous areas, like on Highway 603. Crews are trying to get out there on boats now, the National Guard, trying to get out to people who can get those residents who are stuck in those homes out of their homes and onto higher ground. That work's really just started. Over the night, we had about 8,000 customers from Hancock County that were without power. Hancock County, of course, the one closest to the Louisiana line. Harrison County in the middle, Jackson County on the side. All the coastal counties are dealing with power outages and problems as a result of what Isaac did here. The mayor of Bay St. Louis walking over to talk to me. Mr. Mayor, coming to give me an update on some information. Hey, Mr. Les, come on, we're on. As he's been surveying the damage and everything that's been going on there, man's been quite busy. We're live, Mr. Mayor. How you doing? Well, you give me the latest information. We're live on TV. Okay. What can you tell me? What have you seen?
Well, in all of our low-lying areas, we still don't have access yet. They're still inundated with water. Highway 603 is reopened, and we've got Mississippi Department of Transportation and our crews out there removing the last little bit of debris from there. So our main corridors will be completely reopened. But other than that, we're just anxiously awaiting a point in time where we can get down into some of those areas, and it doesn't look like the water's going to let up.
You were talking about a concern for your public workers being able to get into places where they don't need to go just yet.
We're not going to put them in water. We are not going to put them in standing water for a lot of reasons. You know, not only do we not know what kind of contamination could be there, but we could have live electrical lines and all of the other regular hazards that come with being in water. So we're going to wait until the water is completely off the roadways before we try to get down in there and assess it. And hopefully the only thing that we're going to be looking for out there is some scattered property damages. We really hope that everybody's out of there. I think most people heeded the warnings to evacuate. There were several rescue missions where people panicked, you know, that had decided to stay. We went out and got them out. So to our knowledge, there's not many people out there. And the ones that are out there have hunkered down and they've weathered this thing.
Last year I spoke, no reports of any injuries. Is that still the case?
Still the case. We have not had a major injury reported yet. So we're very thankful for that.
Mayor Les Villengain, Mayor of Bay St. Louis, thanks for coming to talk to Mr. Mayor. So that's the latest right now on what they're dealing with here. Some residents still stuck in the flooded areas. They're going to get to them as soon as that water goes down. Live in Bay St. Louis, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.